So the left D-pad button of this Joy-Con is not working. Ever wonder how to fix it? Let's get started. These are the tools used in this video. When any of the D-pad buttons or the ABXY buttons of the Joy-Con or any other controller is not working, then most of the time the button membrane sticker contact is dirty and no replacement is needed. We just need to disassemble it and clean it with isopropyl alcohol. But wait, it's not that easy after all. Now get the tools and begin to disassemble the Joy-Con. For this kind of repair, we need to get into the PCBA, so we need to disassemble the Joy-Con completely. This is the PCBA of the left Joy-Con. I will peel the left D-pad membrane sticker and clean the contacts under it. Set the hot air temperature to about 100 degrees Celsius and begin heating the board. Point it to the left D-pad. Since it is hard to hold the hot air myself, I had to use a hot air stand. By the way, if you don't have a hot air rework station, you can use a hair dryer. When the board is warm enough, get the craft knife and peel the sticker carefully. If you don't hit the board or the membrane, it doesn't mean you can't peel it, but it is harder and might break the sticker. And be careful with the craft knife, try not to scratch the PCBA. Get a blunt tweezer and continue peeling until the left button membrane is fully uncovered. And this is how it looks. Basically, we need to clean the pad and the metal plate with isopropyl alcohol. No soldering required. Wet the paper towel with isopropyl alcohol and begin cleaning those contacts. And be careful not to rub too hard, or else the metal plate will come off. And you can stick the button membrane back to its place. The next step is optional. If you don't find any broken PCBA tracks or other damage, you don't need to do this step. But if you have a multimeter, then testing the D-pad button before putting it back together won't hurt you. You want to test these two pads that represent the left D-pad button. Set the multimeter to continuity test and test the D-pad button. It is tricky due to the size of the pads, but it is doable. You need to press the D-pad button and observe the value on the multimeter. OL means no continuity. If the value changes or you hear the beep sound while you press the D-pad button, it means the D-pad button is working fine. I heard the beep sound and the DMM value changes, so I think the D-pad button is fixed now. Let's put everything back together. Before installing the last 4 screws, let's test the left D-pad button. It is now good. Okay, it is totally fixed now, and I have no doubt installing the last 4 screws. And that's it. That's how I fixed the left D-pad button. If it doesn't work for you, then your Joy-Con might have other problems. Thanks for watching this video. Cheers!